In honor of Small Business Week, how are you going to celebrate your small business? I know that we are all super crazy busy, but stop and think about it for a minute. Are you really busy doing the right thing? Like the right things to grow your small business? I know most of the small business owners that I consult with, they are just trying to figure it out. It is not easy to have a small business. Otherwise, everybody would do it. You know that cheesy saying, you have to love yourself first before someone else can love you? I'm gonna go there. I'm gonna be a little cheesy. How much do you love your business? Thank you lovingly for the beautiful dried flower. No, seriously, like you have to love your business. You have to love your team members. You have to love your processes, your technology, your strategy. Otherwise, if you don't love what you're doing or how you're doing it, how in the heck can you expect your clients to love? So here's a few things to consider in elevating your small businesses. How is the customer service? The follow-up. What's your policy? Like we really try to get back to clients within 24 hours, but let's be honest, when we have events going on or I'm teaching, it's nearly impossible. So the next best thing is to communicate to your clients so they know the expectation. When can they hear from you? How are you going to follow up with them? What are the next steps? You cannot assume that your clients know what the next steps are. They're coming to you because they trust your brand and your business for whatever service you're needing. And that's called setting expectation. And while it seems super easy, it's not, people. The next thing to consider and look into is how are you pre-qualifying your client? What is your perfect client, your dream client, the client that values what you do and the service that you provide? It's okay to say no. You're not for everybody. There's plenty of business to go around, people. The next thing, hire good people. And it's really hard to find, trust me, I know. But surround yourself with people who are not like you, people who are going to challenge you as a business owner to grow your business and identify blind spots. It's just a different way of thinking, a different way of seeing things. It's just a mindset. And when you do have a team, it is imperative, like so important, that you identify the role of each individual. What are they responsible for? How are they helping the company grow? What is their why? What is the meaning? Because as a small business owner, we cannot do everything ourselves, okay? Like I would drown. And as you have a team and you grow a team, you've got to instill culture and ensure that your team members are handling things the way that you would handle them. And that all comes down to leadership, communication, and culture. One of my favorite things that we do is create a language brand guide, meaning there's specific words that I just don't like personally. For example, I can't stand it if people say, no problem. I mean, it's a negative. It's a double negative, actually. So instead, you can consider saying, absolutely, of course, you're welcome. I've also learned with psychology that people are more receptive to your feedback when you say the word consider, instead of saying, you need to do this, you need to do that. It's like you're a kid and your parents are yelling at you. So think about the culture that you want to create in your small business. And as a leader, how are you going to empower others around you? That is super, super important. Oh, and I just have to throw this in there, networking. Typically, the owners of the companies of small businesses, or they will hire a face or someone to go and network for them. Make sure that it's intentional networking. Don't just go or send people for the free food and the free booze. Like, be super intentional about it. Otherwise, it is a waste of time. And we don't have time to waste. I don't, do you? I just got back from a trip with the EO organization in Macau and Hong Kong. And it actually really hit me like hard about how amazing it is to live in America and have the opportunity to be a small business owner, to be a leader, to become an expert in the creativity field. America alone has over 30 million, that's a lot of zeros, small businesses that are so central to our economy and our local communities. And listen, I get it. It takes courage. It takes risks. It takes a lot of sleepless nights and a ton of determination and a ton of courage. Did I already say that? To run and lead and grow a small business. So what are you going to do this week to celebrate? Well, if you need some ideas, just share your story through video, through a blog, and say thank you to the people that help you grow your small business. Amanda, Aja, Leslie, Samantha, Dami, and Alex, my whole team, you know who you are. Thank you for sticking by me through all my crazy ass ideas and sometimes talking me down. And I love small businesses so much that my next journey is spending time in another new small business called Collective 615, which is a co-working space that is opening so soon. So if you're around Nashville, come check us out. Go to collective615.com and come sit with us and feel the culture that we have created. Happy National Small Business Week. Have a great one.